All right, guys, August 20th, 2024, back again. Keith Archer with Ultimate Egg Cure, Ultimate Shrimp Cure, and Ultimate Shrimp Cure High Octane, okay? Today, we're gonna talk salmon eggs, and we're gonna give you some of what I do and how I do it. So pay attention, this is a good one. If you haven't yet, subscribe to the channel. This is gonna kind of be a multi-session, all right? We're gonna talk about curing eggs, preserving eggs, what we do to freeze our eggs, and then how to bait eggs kind of today. And then down the road here over the next few sessions, I intend to show you how I use eggs in applications, whether it's hover fishing, side drifting, drift fishing, bobber fishing, back bouncing, all these sorts of applications and how I rig eggs to be prepared for that, okay? So let's start with curing eggs, all right? First things first, I use gallon jars, okay? I've done this since, I was probably 17, 18 years old. I've had these jars since I was 17, 18 years old, and I've got 6, 7 of them. They each do about 7 pounds of eggs, okay? So let's start with the skein. Let's talk about skeins and what they look like. We were fortunate enough yesterday to get out fishing, catch some fish, caught some hens, did some eggs up yesterday so I can get ahead on one set batch of the eggs. Gonna do some up today to kind of bring you up to speed on what it looks like and what I do. First things first, okay? Different types of fish right now. We've got upriver brights in the river system, okay? These skeins have much, much smaller berries, okay? And then we have tules in the system right now, where these skeins are much larger berries, okay? If I was able to pick, I would pick tule, okay? Their maturity level is further along in the process. And let's talk about this for a second, okay? Because this is super important. I think everybody thinks a salmon egg is a salmon egg, right? They are, okay? But they're not. And then what I'm talking about is the maturity level of the salmon egg itself. Let's think about that for a second. It itself is a big, big, big deciding factor on how I fish those eggs, what I do with those eggs, and more importantly, the results I'll likely get with those eggs, okay? Immature eggs, super small eggs, I tend to set aside for drift fishing, side drifting, and maybe a little bobber fishing, depending on the, you know, the length of casts I'm gonna be making and those sort of things, all right? The larger buried, or let's start with the mid-level buried egg, these eggs, if I could have 200 pounds of these eggs, these are the eggs I would have. Perfect size, okay? Perfect, absolute perfect look, perfect tightness. You can see as I'm rolling the skein around, there's not a whole lot of air gaps, there's not a whole lot of separation between the skein themselves, are not broken down, the skein quality is super dense, heavy. Okay, that's really important when we go to hover fishing or back bouncing or those sort of things where we want these eggs to retain the scent. Okay, I feel like there's a big step here that a lot of, you know, as far as a learning curve for everybody, you know, the eggs, where they come from, what strain of fish are they? All these things do factor into the results you'll get with the eggs. Now that's kind of an advanced expert level type thing. But that's 25, 30 years of me, okay, keeping notes, paying attention, what works, what's worked where, and those sort of things. It is definitely a common thing. It is definitely patternable to be able to say eggs from certain rivers, fished in certain rivers, do better than others. Eggs with certain maturity levels in certain rivers do better than others, okay? So we'll talk more about that down the road. Let's cure some eggs. All right. See how tight this skein is, okay? The front half of the skein, all right? It's nice and enclosed still, right? So how do I get cure inside these eggs? This is what I do personally, okay? I lay this skein over like so, okay? With the back of the skein in my hand, all right? And then I'll start here with the scissors. Now let's talk about scissors for a second. Kid scissors, okay? These kid scissors are really, really important. They do not pop the eggs, okay? It's sharp scissors, things like that. If you work the eggs over with sharp scissors, you're gonna pop quite a few eggs as you're butterflying these skeins. So start with a simple little pair of these. I have them everywhere. I have them for cutting baits in my boat. I have them for obviously curing the eggs themselves, okay? So we're gonna go right up the middle and I'm just gonna bury these scissors in and I'm just gonna cut right down the middle, okay? You can see it cutting. It's not popping any of the eggs. Now the skein's laid open. You see that? I'm gonna take it further, okay? A little bit further. Now we're almost completely opened up skein, right? Now I'm gonna bring this up in my hand and I'm actually gonna take and just start working right up the middle, the back line of the skein, okay? Now I've butterflied two sections, see here, okay? Now I bring my jar in and I just start cutting about 2-inch long pieces, like so, okay? About 2 inches, drop them in. 2 inches, drop them in. 2 inches, drop them in. Then I go back to the middle. I'm butterflying up the middle. Okay, following me. 2 inches, 2 to 3 inches, whatever it is. Okay, now I've got my skein in the jar. Okay, there it is down there. Egg gear, all right? How much? Great question, all right? Some people use little, some people use a lot. Tell me what kind of texture you want, okay? If you want more of a gummy bear type egg, you wanna add more, all right? What I personally add, okay, is about, all right, real quick, how to make an edit. First time I've had to edit in a lot of these videos. I use 3/4 ounce of cure to 1 pound of eggs, okay? But let me take that a little bit further. I'll use about 1/2 ounce of cure for a super immature egg. A medium maturity egg is gonna be around 3/4 ounce to a mature egg, a larger buried egg, a little bit more looser on the skein. I'll use about 1 ounce of cure to 1 pound of eggs. This is 14 ounces of dry powder, okay? So that means you're gonna get somewhere between 14, 17, 18 pounds of eggs cured, all right? 14 to 20 ounce pounds of eggs cured, because most eggs are medium maturity and above. Follow me? Thank you. Back to it. That's been kind of my sweet spot where I've found the best successes, okay? The best color, and then the best firmness, right? Now, firmness can be also something else that comes from the time of which you cure the eggs, right? A lot of people today, in today's world, have been taught to cure eggs 2-3 days and freeze them. Okay? No. All right? One of the things I do is I cure eggs 7 to 12 days, depending on the maturity level of the egg. These larger berries, mid-level berries, I'm gonna cure these somewhere between 10 and 12 days, okay? An immature berry, I'm gonna cure, the other first skein that I shared with you, I'm gonna cure 7 to 8 days, okay? Why am I curing them so long? Let me explain that, okay? Here's the cure. We're gonna start adding some cure real quick, and we're gonna keep curing as we're talking, all right? So I use 3/4 ounce of cure to 1 pound of egg. Cut up and add it in, all right? So I'm gonna dump that in. I'm just gonna lay it in. It's kind of an eyeball thing, about like so. I'm gonna toss the lid on. One of the things about my cure, super fine chemicals, all right? Keep it away from your face, keep it away from your nose, because it will, you know, I mean, it's very fine. It easily will come up and grab you, all right? So let's go to skein number 2. All right, the maturity of the egg, okay? The maturity of the egg, I take down that path, as I've said earlier, okay? The time that I cure these eggs, the length of curing process, all right? We're butterflying this skein as we're opening it up, okay? Taking a look again, we've got it butterflied open. All right, we're just gonna drop in 2-inch piece. Sorry, so much to think about and talk about here. I'm gonna get through this skein and then we'll go ahead and work on curing time, all right? Let me just finish this one up. Drop in a chunk. Now, when you get to this part of the skein where it's kind of more opened up, all right, I just go ahead and chunk it up. I gotta know that the eggs, the cure, can get through these sections of the eggs, right? That simple, okay. I'm gonna drop in another 3/4. Done with that, set it aside, all right? Now, once I've put the cure in, you can see it all in here with the eggs. What I'll do is, why I like a jar is I can just roll them, right? I can just roll them in my hands, just kind of shake them up like so. And again, be careful with jars. It takes a little time and a little use to get in this. If you drop one of these, it's not gonna be a pretty thing. But once you shake them up, okay, they're gonna be just kind of coated a little bit. And then we'll set those aside. I typically go put those in a refrigerator and I'll come back in about an hour, okay? And then I'll shake them up again. I started these yesterday. Look at the color of those, okay? Absolutely the most vibrant eggs that you will find on the market. The brightest salmon eggs that you will find, period, okay? The way I've formulated this cure, the way I've done things with this formula, there's not another cure on the market that does as far as brightness, all right? So these were cured yesterday. The first thing you're gonna see is you're gonna see them dump the juices, okay? And what I mean by dump the juices is I get people that reach out to me and say, hey Keith, I got my eggs are just like super wet. Totally normal, okay? That happens in that first 12 to 24 hours. And then all of a sudden they're gonna start reabsorbing the juices, okay? They're gonna start pulling them back in. So as they're pulling them back in, all right, I just take this jar, you know, once in the day I'm curing, just kind of flop them around in there, just kind of flop them around, get them shook up a little bit like so, okay? And then the next morning I get up, I'll go back out and I'll just roll them, okay? Roll them up, get them shook up a little bit. Don't beat the heck out of them, just roll them up. And then that evening, I'll do it again, okay? 7 to 12 days, let's talk about this. This cure is designed to reduce the lipids and the proteins in these eggs molecularly, okay? And what's that for? I want it to become a scent trail that's 2, 5, 10 times any other egg cure out there, right? So it's reducing the smells, or reducing it molecularly, reducing it, the lipids, the oils basically in these salmon eggs, and those are dispersing through the water column much, much, much quicker. So when you drop these eggs in a hole, they become more vibrant as far as how that scent trail disperses through the water column. Does that make sense? That does not happen day one, day two, or day three. That process, okay, that fermentation process takes 5, 6, 7 days to start happening. 8, 9, 10 days, we're really into it. 10, 11, 12 days, we're completed. We're ready to freeze the eggs. So let's talk about freezing the eggs, okay? How do I put them away? It's really important. I have eggs that I pull out that I've shared over the time here that I think you guys have watched earlier in some videos on the channel. I have eggs that I've fished that are 10 years old, 15 years old, 20 years old. If they're put away correctly, you will absolutely 100% be able to save these in a freezer for 5, 10, 15 years, okay? What is the one thing that will break these eggs down? Oxygen, okay? That will cause freezer burn. So if we take away all oxygen and we remove all oxygen from the jar, the eggs can't freezer burn. You may have the top level of the eggs where they kind of get a little bit freezer burnt a little, pull that top level off, throw them away, and the rest of the jar, okay, is gonna be absolutely beautiful. Now I can put my eggs away. I'll put them away in pints and I'll put them away in quarts, okay? So it's all up to you and how you guys, based on the size of the trip you're gonna do, whether you're fishing your own eggs or you're fishing with buddies, that sort of thing, is how much you put in, or whether you do more pints or more quarts, okay? So for example, okay, these are only day one, right? So these are not ready to be frozen yet, but I'm gonna show you how I pack my eggs in my jar so that you can be prepared to put them away long-term. Again, I'm gonna let these go, the maturity of these eggs, I'm gonna let these go about 8 days before I put them away, okay? So let me dig in here. We're just gonna start dropping skeins in. And I'm gonna bring this up a little bit closer so I can show you what I'm doing, okay? So as I'm dropping these in, and look at those eggs, you guys. I mean, absolutely just freaking gorgeous. Look at those. Just absolute. Oh man. Okay. See how these are laying in here and you're seeing lots of little air pockets around the bottom of the jar down in this section here. Okay. I just take my fingers and I always use gloves. Okay. But I just massage the eggs, the edge of the jar. I'm massaging the edge of the jar and I'm just pushing the eggs down in. Follow me. Okay. Just like so. And I'm not pushing them so hard that I'm popping the egg. I'm just massaging them down in. Now look, as we rotate this, very little oxygen showing itself. You see that? There's a little air pocket right there. Okay, I'll just kind of work that down. Kind of work that out. If you get one or two little air pockets, that's okay. But here's what's gonna happen. When you cure these eggs, day one, like I said, they're gonna juice out. Day two, day three, they're gonna pull the juices back in. Day three, day four, day five, they're gonna be kind of starting to juice back out again. And then they'll go through that same process where they pull the juices back in. Not quite as much as they did on the, day 5, 6, 7, as much as they did on the first day. Or day two, day three. Day 7, 8, 9, 10, they're gonna release more juices again. And that's the time that I start to prepare to put them away, okay? So when I'm done packing these full, okay, and I'll put just a couple more little chunks in here to give you the example, okay, where I fill the jar to, mind you, okay? Now this jar is full, okay? So I'm gonna massage this juice or these oxygen pockets out, just like so. Now that jar is just about ready to be put away. I would massage it just a hair more. As far as filling it, that's it, okay? See the rim line? Do not fill these to the top, okay? If you fill these to the top, the eggs will expand when you freeze them, and when they expand, they're gonna crack jars. So don't fill them to the top. So that's about as far as I would go, and maybe even just like a quarter inch less, all right? So those are prepared, ready to be put away. Additives, I get lots of questions about additives. Keep in mind, I prepared and made an egg cure that is my personal favorite through and through, up and down the West Coast, Oregon, Washington, Alaska. Lots of great reports coming from the Great Lakes, lots of great reports for steelhead and salmon, all right? They work, try it. how do I rig an egg? Okay. Egg loop. Obviously, you can look this up on YouTube, how to tie an egg loop. Okay, I got a pre-cut little bait here. Super important when I put my eggs on that I keep them spherical. So as you lay the eggs on, they want to kind of fall. I just wrap those back up over the top. Okay, we're getting closer to a sphere, and I'll use the egg loop itself to help me make near perfect sphere. Okay, so when I pull this up tight, the eggs sit there, and there they are. All right, so recap. If you haven't yet, subscribe to the channel, hit the button below. All right, gonna be lots more coming. I'm gonna teach you not only how to cure the eggs again, go through that some more, but what other chemicals I'll add from time to time, depending on the fisheries that I'm going to fish, and then the applications of bait smells, bait oils, all these sort of things. I got lots to share. So pay attention, stay tuned. And if you haven't yet, Ultimate Shrimp Cure hoodies, Ultimate Shrimp Cure t-shirts, got lots of those. Coon shrimp, guys, if you're out running coon shrimp, Columbia River right now, small coon shrimp. Okay, that was the trick yesterday and what helped us get to the fish load, or the numbers of fish we caught. So definitely downsize right now. They're not quite in that phase where the water temp's correct. This warmer water keeps them eating just small offerings. But when that water temp drops, they're gonna be more aggressive and they're gonna start eating like piranhas, all right? So, all right, guys. There it is. It's available in all the retailers, okay? Locally, Anglers West, or Anglers Unlimited, Edge Pro Shop, Bob's Sporting Goods, Fisherman's Marine Supply, Cabela's, Bi-Mart, Amazon. The list goes on and on and on. I'm getting messages and contacts up and down the West Coast from stores. There's even places in the Great Lakes that are already starting to stock this stuff. So UltimateEggCure.com, go to the Facebook page, Ultimate Egg Cure, TikTok, Ultimate Egg Cure, Instagram, Ultimate Egg Cure, and the same for the Ultimate Shrimp Cure, okay? BestCoonShrimpCure.com, go to the website, lots of information, tutorials, videos on both, okay? Good luck out there. If I see you, say hi. I'm here to help. Have a good one.